thank you.
Jamie, is there anything I can get for you?
No, thank you.
That will be all of it.
Hello, Mom.
Hello, Jamie.
I'll be back.
Bye.
You're looking good.
You're looking tired.
Thank you.
You wanted
to talk to me.
Yes. You talked to Mom yesterday?
Yes.
And Mac? Did you talk to Mac?
Yes.
Well, then I guess that what I say to you won't come as a total surprise.
Excuse us, Sally and I have to talk. Jerry, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm terrific. Come on, sit down right here. Look, you guys wait here. I'm going to be right back.
Sandy, where are you
going? I'm going to go ditch the van. Did you get everything out of it?
Yeah, I double-checked.
Okay, good. I'll get the tickets. I'll also check this bag.
Okay. Sandy, where are we going?
Safest place I know. Because it's the easiest place to get lost in. New York City.
And now, the continuing story of another world.
Yes, it's still a surprise. It'll take me more than a day or so to get used to the news if you're about to tell me that it's over between you and Mac.
Yes.
Just like that?
No, not just like that, but it is over.
You told me.
No. I wanted to tell you first.
So did Mac. He felt I should be warned of a possible breakup.
That seems everyone saw it coming but me.
What do you mean? Saw it coming. You say it as if it were an unavoidable act of fate that your love is being killed, but you're wrong. You've had every opportunity to change what's about to happen, but it's been your choice not to.
Jamie, you don't know enough about this situation. It was certainly not my choice.
Well, I'm sorry, but I find the fatalist attitude very difficult to believe. Mom, what is happening to all of us?
Do you think this is easy for me, Jamie? This is quite a struggle for me. In this last year, everything I have ever believed in, everything I've ever felt sure of, has changed. And that's very unsettling, very confusing, very depressing. But through all of this, Mitch has been there for me. And I choose to be with him.
You see? It is a matter of choice. Come on, Mom. Mitch Blake? What is happening to you? How can you be so self-destructive?
Jamie, I have been deceiving myself all year. I can't do it anymore.
No. I think you're deluding yourself. Don't you see how it'll hurt you in the long run? And then who are you going to turn to? Not Mac. Not Amanda.
I will never give up Amanda.
You might not be asked.
I know I won't be asked.
The courts might make that.
Better not ask Mac that. You might not agree.
I don't
Jamie,
have to
I've
tell
been
you
here
how
before.
Mac loves
I will
Amanda.
Never consent to give up Amanda.
She's his only.
You may not be asked.
I know
not
I won't be
give
asked.
Give that up lightly.
The courts might make that decision for you. You should understand that. After all, you've done everything you could to make sure that Mitch has had access to Matthew. Mom, I believe very strongly that Mac is going to move heaven and earth to keep Amanda. Especially since he's about to lose the rest of his family.
No, darling, he will try and buy heaven and earth to keep Amanda, and it is his choice to break up this family.
Mom, let's not play games, okay?
Now think about what you're doing. Mac loves you. Give it another chance before it all gets destroyed. I know you must still love him, and now this Mitch Blake guy comes along.
I love Mitch. You're going to have to understand that, Jamie. A few weeks ago, you were in this very room trying to convince me that you loved Cecile.
Yeah, I tried. Did I succeed?
Yes.
Oh, so you believe now that Cecile is the right woman for me? Mom, you really amaze me. On the one hand, you refuse to accept Cecile. And on the other hand, you expect me to be overjoyed at the prospect of having Mitch Blake as my stepfather. Mom, this man is responsible for, one, getting involved in a plot to kill Mac, seducing and fathering your child. He's also responsible for your being arrested, tried, convicted, sent to prison for his murder, and now he's returned for the final breakup of your marriage. Your whole family! Is this the man that you're in love with? Well, I'm sorry. My Cecile is a sweetheart compared to your Mitch Blake and his resume.
Jamie, you're going to have to accept this. It's the way it is.
Back to life, huh?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, I think that's the way Max sees it, too. He says he's filing for divorce.
Look, Mrs. Frame, I'm very sorry.
Don't
I know I shouldn't be bringing
her.
Sally home.
I have
home
been
this
frantic.
Night.
I had no idea where Sally was. Just how do you expect me to react? Leigh, if you'll excuse us, please.
Yeah, sure.
Look, maybe we can borrow the apartment again. Like maybe tonight.
I'll call you about it later.
Okay. As long as you live in my house.
This isn't your house. This is Grandpa's.
That's beside the point. Look, you're living with me. I'm responsible for your support. Therefore, I expect you to abide by the rules that I set down.
What rules are these, Mother? That I get good grades and I'm in bed by 10 o'clock?
Sally, don't exaggerate. You know, I've never been that strict with you.
How come for as long as I can remember, I have never been able to do what my friends can?
Let's leave your friends out of it. It's you I'm concerned about.
Okay, well, I just want to know what exactly is expected of me.
Well, if you're going to be late, call me. Mm-hmm. That's only common courtesy.
That's what you call it. I call it an intrusion into my affairs, and I will not
let
you treat me like that.
Me this way.
I am beginning to feel like a caged animal around here. You know, I'm an adult now, and I can live any way I choose to.
You know, you're not on your own yet, Sal. And as long as you live in this house, you can't live any way you choose.
Yeah, well, I guess I know what I have to do then. I'll just move out.
Honey. That'll take money. Where are you going to get it?
Well, don't you worry about that, because I'll find a way.
This rule against carrying sick people, so I can't give them the impression that there's anything wrong. You're going to be able to walk?
Announcing the boarding for flight number 27, departing at 10:30 a.m. from gate number 3. On the board, please.
I'll make it.
Yeah, baby, I know you. Come on.
Let's do it. Sort of refreshment, but it is a special occasion.
certainly will. Well, Jordan, I've got to say that I had my doubts there for a while about whether you did what you wanted.
No. About whether you were the man to pull this one out of the fire, so to speak.
Well, nothing speaks louder than success.
I hear you.
And now, all we have to do is be the ones to buy the bargain on the fire sale, so to speak.
No problem. I understand it's the frame kid who'll be handling the sale. He should be a snap to handle. And then?
What?
Well, with all that nicely wrapped up, home for the hunter. I should be in St. Louis by the weekend.
Oh, for how long? Maybe for good. Yeah, but just what about the operations here?
An interesting question. I've been meaning to talk to you about that. I'm placing you in charge here in Bay City. But with one provision.
Well, sure, just anything, you know me.
Get that little mess with Blaine cleaned up. Will you?
Statistics, Hans is just what I've been waiting for. Now we'll find out exactly who Sally Alexander really is. So it's true. Sally is Matt Corey's son. Hello, Pat. Today.
Why, thank you. Do you want anything?
No, nothing in particular. I was just wondering if you'd seen Sandy this morning.
No, Max said he won't be in for a few days. Something about family problems.
I thought that Sandy didn't have any relatives in Bay City.
I guess he doesn't. That's why Max said he went out of town.
Sandy comes back that he should spend more time working with me.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I was thinking that I might ask Jamie to assign him to me full time. Or we'd get somebody else for you, of course.
Of course.
It wouldn't bother you.
Would it make any difference if it did?
If that's what you want and you ask Jamie for it, I'm sure you'll get it. Yes, so am I.
It's the phantom nurse of Bay City General. Looking all over for you.
I don't know why. You know where the nurse's schedules are.
Well, that's why you didn't return my phone call, huh?
I thought it was superfluous.
Such a big word, superfluous.
Rick, I somehow had a feeling that we may have had this upcoming conversation before.
Why don't we have this conversation, sister dear?
Is something bothering you?
Me? Bothering me? What should be bothering me?
Seriously, Rick.
Seriously? Your brother walks into his friend's apartment and finds his sister in his friend's arms, who happens to be her ex-husband. And something should be bothering me?
Our predecessors has acquired an unbelievable amount of which has been stocked in the warehouse, so I fell back on putting any orders in for the month, which should save us a lot of money.
Well, that's good. Great. What's our next item?
Our next item, Jamie, is something that I've been stalling for a long time, but it can hardly wait any longer.
Oh, what is it?
Well, that's replacing of the presses. Jamie, before the fire, I had the unconditional guarantee that if anything should break down here, I could always go over and use Cory Publishers. Use their presses. Now we no longer have that security. I mean, if anything should happen now, we'd really be in trouble, so we've got to replace them. I mean, just ordering them will take several months in arrival.
So you put the order through, right?
No.
Why not?
Why should you think you would understand, Jamie? I mean, your order was contingent with whether or not I was going to get the report so that I would know the financial limitations of expenditures at the ledger. But in case you don't remember...
No, I remember.
Well, you didn't remember to give me the report, Jamie. Now, it's very important that you understand that I know that you've been carrying quite a heavy load here. And so I reminded myself to step back and not bother you. That is your wife.
Leave Cecile out of this, okay?
No, don't say that. I have no intention to bring Cecile into this. Jamie, we're friends. This is not a personal attack on you. I understand you've been carrying a heavy load. You've been doing more than you share.
Not more, okay? It's a fair share.
All that I can say is that I can make any decisions right now on any of enormous investments for the company unless I have some kind of a discussion with you and you give me that report so that I can organize any of the ordering or any of the necessary payments. You do understand that?
Yes, you're right.
Just as long as you understand, Jamie, that I cannot make a move without your participation. That would be very irresponsible of me. And you understand it would also be very irresponsible of me if I didn't tell you right now that number one priority was to get rid of those old machines and bring in some new ones that would run smoothly. Just in case something should happen. Now, you do understand that,
don't you? Of course I understand that. Look, I'm sorry, Philip. I forgot about the report. I'll get it to you right away.
That's a good idea. Now, you tell me what is right away.
Tomorrow. I'll get it to you tomorrow.
I mean, you and Joey know each other very well. After all, you used to be husband and wife.
Do you think I've forgotten?
I thought maybe you'd need a little reminding.
Well, I haven't. Where do you get off with this old-fashioned concern when it comes to my relationship with my ex-husband? I mean, he comes to my aid and you act as if you'd found us in some compromising position, and I resent that. I mean, I appreciate the fact that Joey and I can be friends, especially now when we meet each other.
Okay, but I just think that you're forgetting a minor detail in all this.
And what's that?
The fact that you're supposed to be in love with Jerry. And here he is out on the road, sick, and you're in the...
Sick? What do you mean?
Look, I don't want to go into it.
You don't want to go into it? You're ready to come here and dissect my relationship with my former husband, and you know something about Jerry that you haven't told me, and you want to climb up? Rick! What do you know?
Blaine called Joey's apartment.
What did you want?
Jerry was very... Jerry was running a high temperature and wouldn't go to the hospital. Blaine got very worried and called Joey for advice. I just happened to be there. I prescribed some antibiotics and Sandy took them down.
Down? Where?
Now, they wouldn't tell me. Sandy thought it was safer that I didn't know.
Are there that much danger?
Jordan's got involved. I don't think they're taking any chances. Listen to me. You can't tell anybody about this, all right? Not even Marianne. That's why... Why Blaine nor Jerry would call me in the first place. And apparently, maybe you'd be in a lot of danger if anybody knows that you know what they're about.
Rick, how much longer can Jerry take it?
This is what I don't know. Not if the antibiotics that I gave him don't do the trick. I'll have to get him to a doctor quick.
Mr. Frank. Well, I'm really flattered that you decided to make a return visit.
Yeah, well, after my last... rather dramatic appearance, I was afraid you wouldn't let me through the door.
No, come on. You weren't all that bad.
No?
Yeah. Everybody drinks a little too much occasionally. Usually makes you feel so sick you don't want to do it again for quite a while.
Right.
Well, what can we do for you?
As a bartender, Andy.
Which one? We've got quite a few.
Andy.
You wanted to speak with Andy?
Yes, yeah.
No, I'm sorry, but it's his day off. Come on, it can't be that special.
Huh?
What are your favorite drink? We've got some of the most expert cocktail mixers here. I can make you anything that you'd like, from a Brandy Alexander to a White Lady.
No, thank you.
Okay, well, what can we get you?
Nothing, really. Thank you anyway. I'll pass it up. Maybe next time.
Okay, well, listen. Just remember that you've got a rain check here, okay?
Yeah. Thank you,
Melissa. Thank you.
disgrace us with his presence. What did you do to scare him off then?
I did not. I don't know what I did yet. And... what's so special about Ed? It's a gift that I don't have.
Oh, it looks like Andy's up to his old tricks again.
Well, you can tell me what that means. I mean, what is it? Is Andy Rucko Welch in disguise?
That's better than that. Andy is a candy man.
Drugs?
Yeah. No harm, though. Like white stuff. Mostly ups, downs, you know.
Yeah, I know. And you left that here. That's dangerous.
Okay, so I'll talk to him. No business transactions on premises.
I mean, we're really lucky. Do you know that Andy wasn't here to deal to our young newspaper publisher?
Lucky, huh? He wasn't after a story, sweetheart. I've seen that look before.
What is that?
Just that he wanted some help from Andy, and he wasn't here to give him any help. So he'll find assistance elsewhere. They always do.
Here, come get it, kitty, 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 kitty.
Oh, it'll never come when you call a kitty, kitty, kitty. You gotta call a Gaylord by its proper name. Gaylord.
Come and get it, Gaylord.
There you go.
Mind if I move your delicate whites?
Hey, make yourself at home. You usually do.
So, what's up? Life's a bummer. Life's a bummer. Oh, where does that heavy, deep, philosophical analyzation come from? Analyzation? Might get kicked off the hockey team.
Why? Why? What happened? I thought you were a hot shot hockey player. Then everything was going good.
Yeah, well, I can't get any good grades.
Yeah? I wasn't exactly a Phi Beta 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 myself. As a matter of fact, I couldn't stay in school at all, so we kind of parted ways.
Yeah, well, it looks like I can't stay in school either. I'm not getting any good grades.
Yeah.
It's the only way I can play hockey is if I stay in school. Yeah. Now I got this hassle with Sally.
Well, what hassle with Sally?
Oh, it's not really with Sally. It's with her mom.
Well, what happened?
I don't think she likes me.
Why?
For not bringing Sally home last night.
Well, I don't blame her. I don't think, you know, there's nothing.
Well, I told Sally to call her mom last night so she didn't have to worry.
Yeah.
But I guess she forgot or didn't want to.
Well, listen, let me give you a piece of advice. You have to be cool when it comes to that sort of stuff. You know what I mean? You got to be kind of discreet. You can't advertise what you're doing. You got to be a little subtle.
Sally, come
you know
on.
What I mean?
I'm not advertising, all right?
Yeah.
Maybe Sally is.
We got to tell her not to do it then because let me tell you one thing. No mother, no way is going to dig her daughter staying out all night, ever.
What am I going to do? Come on, I'm crazy about this girl. But I don't need any hassles from her mom. I have complications right now in my life.
No, you just try to be a little bit more discreet.
What, you saying lying?
No, I'm saying don't keep her out all night. If you are going to decide to keep her out all night, then be a bit more cool about it, you know what I mean? Don't advertise it. Be subtle, work things out, but don't be stupid about the whole thing. You're going to drive the mother crazy.
Well, you know, if I get kicked off the hockey team, at least I could get a full-time job. And I could afford getting a place with Sally. We could live together.
Wait. What are you talking about now, getting kicked off the hockey team? You just told me that you like playing hockey. You love playing hockey.
Joey, wait. I want to play hockey. But if I do get kicked off the team, living with Sally wouldn't be too hard to take.
I'm sure the mailroom gets this out right away, okay? Hey, mister. Don't you talk to old friends anymore?
I'm sorry, Pat. I guess my mind was miles away.
Well, they say that travel broadens. Anyway, I'm glad you're not snubbing me.
Oh. No, not at all.
So what are you doing here? Your body, that is, if not your mind.
Well, I came by to see Mac. Dropped in, really. But he's out.
Or is there something wrong?
No.
was recovering from the operation very well. Did he ever read that?
Well, of course you wouldn't know. But Jerry felt that Blaine Ewing was in trouble. Really dangerous trouble. And he's disappeared with her. I talked to Russ about it, and he tells me that there is a danger of a relapse. Possibility of infection.
Well, if Blaine is with him...
Yes, I know. That's what Russ told me.
But if Blaine's aware of his condition, she'll certainly watch him very closely.
I hope so, Pat. I really do.
Oh, you can be sure of it. Blaine is a very determined young woman. If she's made Jerry her responsibility, then you can be sure she'll do it.
That sounds reassuring.
Well, I just wish that I could be sure you believed it.
Slipped out before he realized it. Luckily from here, I'd never know.
The thing was, kid, I just didn't want you to worry about it.
Well, why not? I mean, worrying is a perfectly natural state of mind when you got something to worry about. It was worse than I didn't know anything. Now at least I know. There's a lie.
Well, I could understand Rick's point of view. I mean, he didn't want to tell you about the whole thing because there's nothing that you really could do about the situation. I mean, that you're here and they're wherever they are.
I prefer to be told facts. How I deal with them is my responsibility, nobody else's.
Very well, you figured if you spilled the beans, then about the medication, and then you would know about the infection, so.
Yeah, I know about it already. Only they'd come back to Bay City. Russ and Rick could have given them proper medical attention. We could have gotten police protection for both of them.
I know a little how you're feeling because I'm just as worried about Blaine. I'm hoping that she's just keeping ahead of Jordan's men, you know?
I hope for her sake she can.
Well, at least we know that they're alive, right?
I know. Joey, I know. I know I should be relieved.
I understand how you feel, and I know that you love Jerry. And I understand.
Oh, I thought the hospital would be the easiest place to find a doctor.
Oh, Pat, this is a surprise. What's the matter? You had trouble finding me?
Well, I checked out every room on the floor, and of course you were in the last one.
Well, of course. Of course. Come, sit down. Sit down. What are you doing here? Don't you work for a living?
Huh? Yes. Oh, I came because I have some good news, I guess, and some not so good news.
Well, I'll take the good news first, please.
Well, I think you ought to clean off the spots of your tuxedo and prepare yourself.
For what?
A wedding.
Well, now, wait a minute. No, it's not your wedding. Whose wedding?
No, not mine, I'm afraid.
Honey, if it's going to be a quiz, I'm no good at guessing. Please spell it out for me, will you?
Your niece.
Marianne?
Yes, my Marianne. I'm sure you can guess who the lucky man is, your star intern here at the hospital.
Well, I suppose that's good news, yeah. I've always thought that Rick and Marianne made a fine couple.
I hope they'll make a good couple.
Well, when do I have to have this tuxedo already? Come on, tell me something.
Well, I would do it quickly. They haven't said all the details yet, but I think we won't have to wait very long.
What's the big rush? I mean, I thought nowadays, young people, they like to live together a while, get warmed up to the whole idea.
Russ. They feel that that's going to be necessary. If they're going to play at being married, I think that they should be married.
Oh, well, that doesn't sound like a Rick Holloway train of thought. In fact, Marianne is hardly the impetuous type herself.
Well, isn't it amazing how love changes our judgment?
Yeah, maybe so. All right, what's the other thing? Come on. Well, you said there was something else.
Excuse me. It's not really so much of news. It's I want some information from you.
Uh-huh. Why are we talking in riddles, Pat?
I'm sorry. I saw Brian earlier, Russ, and he seemed unusually tense. And he said he is very concerned about Jerry Grove.
Oh, yes, yes. Well, he has very good cause to be concerned.
Why, have you heard something?
Well, we have learned that Jerry indeed does have an infection.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I'm very concerned about it. But you can tell Brian the next time you talk to him that Jerry is taking medication. Now, if we're very lucky, it just might curb the infection.
Oh, well, that's good news. Okay, I think that will ease his mind. Mm. Thank you.
I just hope that I'm not being too optimistic.
Now, in another year, 4043. If I expect to run down to 35, even if it's about 55, I get.
How's he doing?
His forehead's still very hot. His hands are ice cold. Can't be good, Sandy.
Well, once we get to New York City, I'll get in touch with a doctor I know.
I think it's time for his medication. Have you got it handy?
There's none left. It wasn't doing him much good anyway.
Well, it had to be better than nothing.
He's going to be okay, buddy. A few hours will be holed up in New York. I'll get in touch with that doctor.
Sandy, we are in such a mess. It's bad enough knowing that Jordan Scott's men were after us. And now Jerry's out of action.
He's going to be okay.
You really think so?
Yeah, well, you got to be positive, you know. It's not going to do us any good if I start counting all the odds against us.
You really don't pull any punches, do you? I mean, you tell it exactly like it is.
Look, Blaine, if I thought this was going to be some kind of vacation, I would have left you and Jerry by yourselves. Jordan Scott is a smart man. Once he gets into his head that he wants to find you, he's hiring pros to do it. We're going to have to be really sharp to stay one step ahead of him.
You think they'll figure out about Joey? You think they'll make him talk?
Well, how can they? He doesn't know anything. Only Rick knows. I doubt if I think of asking him.
I don't think I ever got a chance to thank you. You know, you took a real big chance coming down here to help Jerry and me.
Well, I just didn't like the idea of Jerry being sick out there.
I don't think that's all there was to it.
Well, I guess I had some reasons from the past. It's a long story.
It's a long flight.
Not that long. Besides, like you know, I'm on the run, too. And I guess it's a lot like you. It's a situation I just couldn't live with anymore.
Shirts, I got them on sale. They're English broadcloth. Jamie, you haven't even looked at them, have you?
I'm sorry.
Oh, well, you're going to try one on right now because I want to make sure that these fit you. Oh.
I'm sure they're okay.
You know, I had to rush out during my lunch hour to get this for you. I was like babbling at a zoo. You know, I thought that Sandy Alexander was supposed to be my assistant as well as Pat's. You know, once she gets them in her clutches, that's about all she can do.
I'm sure they're fine.
What's the matter? What's wrong?
Shows that much.
I'm your wife, remember? I can see these things.
I want to see Mom today.
Your mother?
Yeah.
It's been a long time.
Yeah, I know. It's been a long time, but she called me. She wanted to see me. So I went over there. And she and Mac are getting a divorce.
No.
Yeah.
Jamie, how's this going to affect you?
What, affect me? That doesn't matter, Cecile.
Sure.
Do you know that this whole thing with Mama Rack is my fault?
Oh, how can you say that?
Yeah, I should have been there for her. I should have been there for her to talk to. I should have been there for her to turn to. Do you know that I forced her into this?
Yeah, will you just stop
it? No, I set up a whole situation, and then Mitch walked right into it.
How can you say that? You can't believe that.
But it's true. Well, I guess it really doesn't matter very much anymore, anyway. She's made her decision. The whole thing is over. It's all over, but the shouting, the yelling, the telling.
You mean she hasn't even spoken to me?
No, it doesn't really matter very much now. He's moved out of the house. Is there any coffee left?
No. I guess I could make some.
Yeah, would you?
You know, I really don't think that you should have any anyway. Oh, I'm going to keep you away.
Well, that's what I'm hoping for. See, I've got this report that I've got to get to Philip, and I haven't even started.
Honey, don't look to me.
Honey, I agree with you. But I promised Philip I'd get it to him tomorrow. And with the way I've been working, I better keep that promise.
Okay. It's your choice. One coffee coming up.
I want to talk to you, and you are not the easiest man to track down.
Sure. What's the problem now?
A very bad habit you've developed lately.
Which one?
Withholding information.
Russ, I'm sorry I told you I couldn't get back to you in time about Jerry.
Yeah, well, that's topic number two. It is not what I'm talking about now.
I don't remember anything.
Well, my sister just told me that you and Marianne are getting married. Now, I am just a little upset that you saw fit to withhold that information from me.
You were next on the release list, huh?
Yeah. Well, all right, then. I suppose you're forgiven for that. But now.
Oh.
Yes. Jerry Grove.
Look, I've been thinking about that. And, I don't think that I handled it with proper responsibility. I'm sorry.
Well, I have been thinking about it, too. And I think, maybe, under the circumstances, that you handled it rather well. Rashly, perhaps, but in Jerry's best interests. And the medical advice that you passed on to Blaine was excellent. All things considered, I suppose that you did handle it all in an entirely professional manner.
Some news for you that may set your mind at ease. Something about Jerry.
What is it?
Well, I went to see Russ a little while ago and found out that he said that Jerry had developed this infection that you were worried about.
Oh, no. That's what I feared would happen.
But, now listen, he started an antibiotic that Russ feels will clear up the infection completely, but unfortunately he can't know for sure. Of course, no one can until Jerry gets proper medical attention.
Did he say where Jerry and Blaine are?
No, I had the impression he didn't know either.
I suppose the less questions asked, the better. But at least someone knows of their whereabouts.
Yeah, exactly. Now we know that Jerry's medical problem is being taken care of.
What a relief, Pat. Oh, and thanks so much for passing the news on to me.
Not at all. Hey, got an idea.
Oh, what's that?
Why don't you let me take you to dinner tonight? I think you could use a little distraction.
Oh, yes, that's a wonderful thought. I'd like that very much.
sorry it took so long. That was for Lisa. You know how she is. When she gets talking, she never stops. She wants to know all about our marriage and hope.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Another World.